Well, hey guys, Easter is a hugely important time for the church. It's a time about the entire history of salvation in Christ coming to die for our sins and be raised again. And it's the absolute essential truth that makes Christianity powerful and effective. And of course, churches always celebrate that in powerful ways. For our church, we do a very meaningful and introspective service on Good Friday. And then we always do something fun on Easter. So we always take movies and shows, that kind of things, and we put the Easter story into them. Here's a few from a few past years.
What now, Jack Savior?
I'm walking on sunshine.
Whoa! We'll die, but in 3 days I will rise again.
Do you speak low German?
Of course I can, sir. It's like a second language to me.
It's Grail, you knucklehead. It is finished.
And in 2020, we had just started The Lion King of Judah. And of course, right before we were able to start, we got a few rehearsals in. We actually did the photo shoot. It all got shut down. And so for 2 years, we've been sitting on this. Now it's 2022, and we're doing it again. And I thought I'd walk you through my whole process of doing the audio for it. Got quite a few steps, but I think you'll enjoy it.
So one of the first parts of the process of Easter is getting some of the songs that are going to be done. So it's always an Easter musical, and we always have fun. We always use secular songs, and they're ones that are fun. And then I go find a legitimate copy. We have all this CCLI, but we also have with all this the secular companies as well. We have reporting and all the copyright stuff, so we're all good to go there. And so right now, I'm just going to take these files and grab the songs.
So I got the first draft of the script today. I have some of the original songs that they might want to use for a walkthrough, which might happen today. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just get those original songs lined up in QLab, which I'm going to get into a lot more detail later. And welcome to the jungle. That'll be fun. Not the first Guns N' Roses songs we've used, won't be the last. So I hope you guys can see that well enough. It's a fairly simple method for so far, but it's a lot more complex as we'll go along.
So I'm not really a photographer, but I am an amateur photographer and I shoot some of the videos at the church, so I have seemed to become the Easter poster photographer.
That looks pretty good to me. We'll start with a few of those.
I can smile?
Yeah.
He's very cocky though.
They're smiling.
There you go.
I like that one. Let's go back
that
one.
That was
a winner.
In 2020, we were actually further ahead than we were in previous years. We actually got a walkthrough in, I think, about a week earlier than usual, and a full script.
So then I was thinking of Matt.
Really close to the screen there.
Yeah, it's actually not bad.
The screen's coming down.
All this will be mine? Sweet!
And from these early walkthroughs, they only need, like, sound effects from me. And then we got a bit of an interruption. We had to put everything on hold, and we had to do all this other stuff for a couple of years.
You don't want too much house ball. You're the original.
I say, guys.
It was really a strange time, wasn't it?
Hello, church, and welcome to Church Online.
So we shelved the script, it went back into the pocket, and the thought was we would revisit it whenever we could. But then as soon as we were able to, we jumped right back in. So, 2022 came around, things were opening up, so we decided to go ahead with the Easter show. So I started by just getting my mics ready for an early walkthrough.
Is everyone here? Are we missing anybody?
Chuck's not here.
We already had the script, we already had the songs.
Is the cast here though?
Already had most of the set made, actually.
Mark, Mika, Matt, Graham, Dirk, yeah.
Had to change out a few actors.
Seems like it.
Right. I don't know about that.
Yeah, we're gonna just have to fix a few things along the way. Look, Simba. Everything the light touches is the kingdom of Judah. And the king of the lions
rules over all.
Wow. I can see Winkler from here.
Yes, that's great.
Oh, and Altona.
Right, okay.
Oh, look! There's Niverville.
Yes, it's all very impressive.
And we always set up a band pit and record most of the band live. They play live, and they have sometimes they have little samples, and occasionally we'll do like a karaoke track. But for this one, I believe everything was live with just a few loops thrown in. I always run a different snake for my personal monitor system. I have all these things ready to go in a back closet to make sure they're ready to go. And I used digital snakes this year, which I thought would be more fun since they were available. Ended up making more hassle than good. But anyway, it's all in the Dante network.
So I'm having to look up fart sound effects for Easter. Sometimes at these moments in life, you wonder if you maybe made a wrong turn in life somewhere. What the heck is that? Now, the method I've developed is not something that is necessarily from, you know, a school for dramatic arts, for musical theater. It's not the line-by-line mixing or DCA mixing some people have heard about. It's something that I was taught by my tech director, Chuck Crocker, something I've adapted myself over the years. So this isn't the only way, or even the recommended way. This is what we've come up with, what's worked well. Maybe you have done, you know, theater productions and music productions and have a different method, so I'd love to hear those as well. But what I'm doing right now, today, is I am working on the script. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to go through and figure out how many different scenes I need. I have all the actors listed and where exactly to switch scenes to take people on and off the stage, add musical cues, all of that kind of thing. And it's quite an intricate process and I go over a lot of notes, but that's what I'm doing today. So the system I was taught was to give every principal actor a color coding and then marking up the script where you want to put your scenes with the system where, you know, a square means add them in, a dash means leave them from the previous scene, and a circle means take somebody out. And every once in a while it's kill everybody for songs or starts of scenes. And now I've gotten to the point where I'm gonna program my scenes, and this gives me a legitimate sense of dread. So I pray about it. There's just so many things that need to be programmed. I won't get into it all, but I have notes I've kept from previous years, and you can see how it's quite the list of things that could go wrong. And if you get something wrong, you have to repeat it like 40 times. Ask me how I know. And so before I make a single scene, I want to get everything programmed well first, and that's what I'm going to be doing for the next little bit. So I'm just about ready to program the scene, so I have put everything into all the appropriate DCAs to send to the broadcast mix, to go to the personal monitors for the bands. I've gotten things going to the regular monitors, what needs to go to the Dugan, all these different various things, and now I'm going to take the markings that I made later and I'll actually program them into scenes. So the first one should be pretty simple, a silence, that should be pretty easy to work with. And I'm naming as I go, which helps a whole lot later on. So I got all of my cues made, and now I want to show you what I do for the audio. So for sound effects, I use this laptop, and I use QLab. Now QLab is a great software if you haven't used it before. It's used for a lot of theater productions. And on the laptop, this is used for launching the quick kind of launched sound effects. So these are things like a motorcycle supposed to drive by. And you can, nice how you can add fades and just have go, go, go and add different sound effects. This is where we have that fart sound effect. Perfect. Anyway, and you can color code things, add fades, it's nice. But then for my bed tracks and for soundtracks, I actually put them on another machine and I actually use MIDI cues. So I have this MIDI adapter here on the back of the board. and I set up the MIDI so that the program change will launch the sound clips from this version of QLab. And so each scene is actually already defaulted to launch a program change number. And in QLab, you can have MIDI be your trigger. The free version, you won't work with a MIDI. You have to actually pay for a license, but in this case, I rent it. So check this out. So I will go to scene 21. As soon as I hit launch, you'll hear the sound effects launch, and I'll show you how it looks on the other side. Now let's look at it on QLab. So I'll hit recall on my scene, and boom.
So yes, in April, in Manitoba, we get blizzards. Yep.
Is this gonna be in your way?
No, as far as I can tell, it's not.
There is a certain excitement and energy around these week of rehearsals that are always really kind of fun and exciting. I love it.
Is Kevin here?
It's also very cool working with my wife, who always plays with the band for Easter.
I thought it was plenty of people showing up at 4, but then actually rolling by 4:30.
So after rehearsals, we always go over things that could be maybe tweaked or improved, even from a tech standpoint. That's my tech director, Chuck.
Now your kingdom, there will be no end.
So for this rehearsal, I had to run both sound effects and the beds, hence both laptops.
You will be king, and of your kingdom, there will be no end.
And on Good Friday, I always like to put a suit on, and it's a much more thoughtful and meaningful day. For this Good Friday, I was running broadcast mix, kind of locked away in a closet, basically. And yet still really connected with the Lord during that service. And of course, on Good Friday, work doesn't stop. Crew still is tweaking last-minute things to the set. This is the rock crew people. We have to take down the Good Friday set stuff, and you see we have to cover the set with a black curtain.
So it is Saturday, April 16th, and today is the day of the first performance, the first service, and we still have some stage being worked on. I mean, my last-minute checks in. I thought I'd show you what they're working on. That looks really good, by the way. Oh, hey, Carlene.
Hey, how's it
going? You feeling good? Feeling ready? How's your liver,
be? Ever really ready?
That should be a fun one.
Yeah, I'm sure it will be.
I'm still looking forward to it, actually. So, I got the Sennheiser app.
So this is Romano. He is my all-star volunteer leader. I think he's better at sound than I am. And I have him doing the broadcast mix because it's still fairly demanding.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, should be good. Sweet.
Yeah, I think, from what I heard online, I think the tuning works really well.
Yeah. Hey, Sam.
And this is Sam. I have him running the sound effects.
The first one there, that motorcycle drive on, you can, fader's up, so you can go ahead.
Okay.
And it's just, it's already blue.
Sam's also been serving in audio for a while and does a great job. Derek is our worship leader and I love working with him too, he's a lot of fun.
That's at the end, yeah, so they're a lot louder. They're competing with the music, so.
Okay. Band was warming up and doing a sound check before the service. Everyone's doing last minute checks, and checking their mics.
Because we've got practice now.
Well, what are you guys doing? Remind me what you guys are doing.
Always a touch awkward, touching all the people, getting their mics ready.
Stuff like this. That, yeah. So by the time we've got to the dress rehearsal, they'd have it. So if they just wanted to tack on to the end.
Hey, happy Resurrection Sunday. So blessed to be able to be a part of an Easter service. Yesterday we had the most people we've had in 2 years. And overall went about 90%, right? They had a little mic that was popping, even though I checked it 5 times, and tiny little audio cues thing. But overall, really successful technically. So today is the big Sunday. It's the Day of a Risen Lord. I so love being a part of this, and hope you get to enjoy the show.
Even though I've done a few of these Easters, there's always a little sense of nerves before you hit that first recall and that first scene. I always say a little paranoia goes a long way with doing audio. This is my audio off of the phone, so it's not going to be perfect.
Life's not fair, is it? You see, I shall never be king.
Dad?
Now, this is actually from our broadcast.
Dad?
This is the mix Romano would have gotten in the broadcast room.
Pop?
Run away. Run away, Simba. Run and never return to the land of Judah.
He's still getting all the audio cues from me downstairs, but he gets them clean so he can mix them himself. And of course, he gets all the inputs from the band separately as well through the Dante network.
Do you know where you are? You're in the jungle, baby.
Back to my phone. Most of the mixes had been mostly dialed in during the rehearsals. Just a bit of finessing as we go through.
They call me Mr. Pig! Ah!
It's alright. This is the way it has to be.
Let's play the game, shall we? I like to call it Skin the Cat. Let's hang this kitty by its paws and see who Mufasa comes to save.
This is the crucifixion lament, or post-crucifixion lament, as some people have called it. Amber is one of our worship leaders, and she does such a good job, such a powerful voice.
You know how the time flies only. Yesterday was the time of our lives. We were born and raised in a summer haze bound by the surprise of our glory days. I hate to turn up out of the blue uninvited, but I couldn't stay away, I couldn't fight it. I had to keep my face, and then you'd be reminded that.
I was trying to boost the reverb just on certain words, and I think I liked that effect. Subtle, but nice.
Never mind, I'll find someone like you.
I have the earthquake sound effect I use every single year. The bassist is right beside the sub, and apparently it loosens his bowels.
What will we do now? Now that Simba is dead.
Correction. Simba is alive.
What? I don't believe it. I thought you were dead.
I was dead. But I have risen, and I will live forevermore!
The greatest story ever told in a way you've probably never seen it before. Why don't you give them a cheer, guys?
And we always do a worship song still.
Stand up.
would probably make sense that we did The Lion and the Lamb.
So I trust you enjoyed our presentation of The Lion King of Judah. And let's
this is the first year Pastor Mark didn't preach the sermon in his costume.
So that was that. Easter is done. It was really powerful. The room was full for all the services, basically. We had an overflow room. People heard the gospel. And yeah, there was some stuff. The second service, I briefly forgot some mute groups, and I had some mics crackle on me. I just didn't have a chance to fix. We were distracting to stop the show. So it's not about me getting it perfect, but the gospel was preached. People heard the message, and that was the important part. Well, hope you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. God bless.